I'm making this video because no one seems eager to talk about this. Not that I don't understand why people don't want to talk about it. Paperbat is known for Minecraft Let's Plays, having a nickname for his fan base.
What's up, champs and champettes? It's your boy P-Bat!
And being generally insecure. Which is to say, he's basically indistinguishable from most lowest common denominator entertainers, and is frankly embarrassing to acknowledge, because doing so says more about you than it does about him. But that's not firm grounds to say nothing about him targeting children. I think that is an exception. I think that's where you cross a line. So here we are. This will mainly focus on a 17-year-old he was dating for a while because there's no hearsay attached to it. It's just proven things that have happened. And before I go any further with this, I know a few of you are probably saying, well, Khonjin, you know the age of consent in some countries is 6, so I think you're just being an asshole. Okay, fair enough. Hey, Dion, what do you think of people who try to go out with 17-year-olds? Oh, you think they're pedophiles who should be run out of town? Okay, then we agree. This is a tweet of Dion calling out the assigned, a streamer who asked out a 17-year-old and got rejected, so he sent his followers after him to run him out of town, and, this happened while he was going out with a 17-year-old. So, you know, it really adds to these really badass lines of, oh, this stuff is already happening on YouTube. I couldn't let it happen on Twitch. Unless, of course, I'm doing it. Then it's fine. So this is a text with him and his 17-year-old girlfriend at the time, and, you know, there's a lot of rumors swirling around about what he did, but then there's this, which is just fact. So I talked to some of Dion's buddies and asked them what their stance on this is, and what I essentially got was, it's completely normal for people to act this way as a response, so basically bullshit. So I do gotta give them props for that response. It's really good. You know what? There's some truth to it, though. When you're in a relationship, not everything is perfect. Bad things happen, and let me tell you something. I have so many exes whom I did not leave on good terms with. I did a lot of bad shit. In fact, any exes, if you're watching this right now, go ahead on fucking Twitter, tag me, write the worst shit I did to you, and I will respond, it's all true, I did that. You know why? Because of anything they could possibly say about me. You know what they can't say? They can't say, you know, Khonjin and I met at the ball pit of a Chuck E. Cheese's. They can't say I met them when they were fucking 16 years old. Look, if you gotta threaten to throw yourself off a cliff to get a 17-year-old to go out with you, go to the fucking gym. Use some of the $14,000 you stole to get a gym membership. The metrics are in. Women don't want to fuck Minecraft Let's Players. Hate to break that one to you, but that's just the truth. Stop beating on your girlfriends and start hitting those bags.
I think it's also worth noting that there is allegedly a 16-year-old he also fucked around with, but in the vein of honesty, there's no hard evidence for this. There's only situations like these really funny joke pictures that he sent to her. I, for one, believe it, because you kind of have to weigh it like this. Who's more trustworthy? Is it Dion, the man who beats on his girlfriends, steals money from his fans, and is being accused of doing something that he fucking did to some other underage girl? Or is it this rando who wants attention? Pick your poison, honestly, because if you believe her, then he preyed on 2 girls, and if you don't, he preyed on 1. It's kind of like, instead of stealing $70,000, he only stole $14,000.
I tried to call the authorities to see if anything could be done about this, and when I got on the line with someone, they told me that they can't take any action unless the victim calls. I don't think I need to explain why that's ridiculous, but since we're already here, the victim is a kid, a child, but no, I'm sure they're raring to go. I'm sure that this person would love nothing more than to call the police and open this Pandora's box when people are already denying it even happened, when there's literally hard fucking evidence. It's not a rumor on the wind. It's a text message with a time and a date that a service provider has access to and can pull up like that. And this isn't ancient history. This isn't from like 10 fucking years ago. This was a few months ago. This was recent stuff. So it's not lost to the tides of time. It's there. And it's still denied, and the denial is believed because this man played Notch's magnum opus. So at this point, I cannot afford to give the hair of a rat's ass as to whether action is taken against him or not. If the Paul brothers have taught me anything, it's that if you are obnoxious enough, you can kill someone on camera and get away with it. So this video is more of a warning rather than a call to action. If you are a kid, an underage kid, a girl underage kid, you probably want to stay away from this guy. If you're an adult, fucking say something. Unless you don't want your pride to be wounded by having his name in your mouth. Oh, to lower yourself to such a level. He's fucking targeting kids. Grow the fuck up. Say something. I know that some of you make a legitimate point that in bringing it up in a public format, it gives him an opportunity to ride on whatever drama's been made. And he is that kind of low-life scumbag who would cling on to anything that gives him relevance. But the only other option is to say nothing. So I say fuck it. Give him his 5 minutes to talk about this bullshit so that you can warn someone, alright? So, that's all I gotta say about that.